just need planning for Naples.
So today is an interesting and exciting day for us as we're about to make four important announcements.
I got here last night when I made this turn, I had to hurt some feelings. They weren't ready for me. I'm probably gonna have to hurt some more feelings again. Probably have to swing out to the left a little bit, so let me go ahead and set up for that. Because that, you probably can't see it from this camera angle, but that is a, that's only two lanes right there. However, dang, this car's got to make a left in front of me. He should be able to make that left. Hopefully I don't get stuck here for two cycles, but yeah. So, come on, dude, make that left. Make it happen. All right. Aw, dude, why didn't you make it? Stupid. All right, pulled up enough. So, because I got this big old wheelbase and this spread axle, I'm gonna have to go on the opposite side of the road to actually make this turn. All right, cleared the curb, so we in there. Last night it was a little bit more traffic coming in. But yeah, gotta get up a couple more blocks, then I gotta hit a left-hand turn at 59th Street, which will take me over by the CSX yard. So if y'all ever have to deliver to Ryerson, this is going on YouTube, if y'all ever have to deliver to Ryerson, it's actually Castle Steel and Wires, the same company. And if you ever need it, I can give you detailed directions, because don't follow your GPS or else you end up under a low bridge. We all know what happens when that happens. Just ask any Swift driver. Golly. Look at those gas prices. $4.69 up here in Chicago. $4.69. That's regular too. Ooh. Okay. All right, Thug Life. Don't you do it. You inched a little bit. I think this is 59th Street. Kind of far back, it's kind of hard to see the sign. We'll see when I get up there. Yep, 59th and Western. Bridge clearance is 13.8 when I make this left. Of course, cars up at the line, and only have 1.5 lanes. So I'm gonna have to hang out here a little bit. I'm gonna get this light though, so I'm gonna pull up an intersection. Y'all waiting for Daddy Gibbs today. Cause if not, I'll be sitting here all damn day. And I've got places to see and things to do. All right, here we go. We're gonna run this curve up a little bit. That car passed the line. It's okay, that's why I'm good at what I do. Alrighty, 13.8, look at that. Bump was so hard it kicked on the music. This guy go, because he ain't never gonna get another chance if I don't deal it. Alright, driver, go on ahead. Sorry dude, I didn't know there was another guy behind him. Another video I'm going to have to show y'all how to float gears. I've actually been wanting to make one for years. But since I've been... Okay, I see you. Since I've been with Walmart, they don't like you filming and driving. And on top of that, I haven't been in a manual all the time. So now I'm back in a manual. And this one's an 18 speed. So I guess I'll show you guys how to drive an 18. Which is not hard. It's really not. It's easy. That Frito-Lay truck kind of put me into the left turn lane because he's sitting out in the road, so yeah. This wheelbase on this Pete is something else. So there's a lot of traffic on 55, what is that, 55 right now, so I'm going to hop on 94 instead. It adds a little bit of, ooh, I thought he was going to hit him. It's going to add a little bit of distance, but I'll get there a little bit faster. I got to pick up at Caterpillar and then head back home to Georgia. Well, deliver in Georgia and then head home from there. Ooh. Y'all wild out here. I'm also driving slightly below the speed limit. I can't wrap my mind around. Look at this guy, I knew it. I just can't wrap my mind around going balls to the wall on these surface level streets right out here in Chicago. One thing I can say about Chicago, if they pull out in front of you, they get in the gas when they do it. A lot of people, they'll just pull out in front of you and then it's like they don't want to drive. At least out here, man, they pull out in front of you, they put that pedal through the floor. Let's go, bus. I'm trying to be nice and let you go, baby. Let's get it. Almost back to the interstate, about a half mile away. Then when I hit the interstate, I'm gonna let some tunes play. Y'all can see what it's like driving on 94 on the Dan Ryan. I don't have to drive the whole thing. Probably gonna be on it for probably like maybe 10 or so miles, if that. But you should see some of the buildings and whatnot. Woo! Look at that, 13.8. Y'all can see it on the sign. Bridge is probably about 13.8 as well. Yeah, there's no sign on this side, but the sign going up stretching, yeah, it says 13.8. Excuse me. All right. So there's our junction for 94 right up there. Excuse me. Welcome to Chicago. Shit, welcome to any big city. All right, time to open her up and let her eat a little bit. Trying to get on, so I'm going to time myself with him, so I can get on his feet. Beautiful. Beautiful. Thank you. Okay, no problem. I'm headed over there to pick up now, so I should get there a little. I'm still trying to get out of Chicago, but I should be getting there about 45 minutes before the appointment, so I'm good. I'll keep you guys updated. That's all right. This truck can go. So that's okay, buddy. Got something for people like you. This truck can go, so we'll make it happen. That's all right. Alright guys, hope y'all enjoyed that little bit of snippet of getting out of Chicago.